Hello guys, so welcome to my channel. So guys, if you have any sound issues in any of my videos, please use headphones and it will be all right. So in continuation to my previous video about of lifeboat inspection, so in my previous video I had explained regarding lifeboat equipments and fittings. So in this video I will be explaining about lifeboat davits, launching and recovery arrangements, and after that the next video will be engines, batteries and lightings, so inspection of that. So in this video I'll be focusing on lifeboat davits, launching and recovery arrangements. So this is the most important part of lifeboat inspection, and many of your doubts will be clarified in this video about the inspection routine. So keep watching till the end, it will be a very informative video. So here I start. Lifeboat davits and the weekly inspection will be the first inspection for the davits and the launching arrangements. So weekly inspection consists of checking of readiness for use. So we have to check, we carry out a visual inspection, and then we have to check the lashings which should be taut. And the third is move from stowage position. So this is what you have to check weekly. So first was the visual inspection, second is lashings. So as you can see here, these are the lashings which are passing around the lifeboat forward and aft. So these lashings need to be taut. Taut means it should be tight, but it should not be excessively tight, or it should not be very loose. That is what is taut. Taut means it should be tight in the way which is not causing too much stress on the wire rope, as well as it's not very loose to damage the lifeboat. That is what taut means. So after that, it is move from stowage position. So this I will cover a separate video to distinguish between what do we mean by stowage, move from stowage position, or and turning out of lifeboats. Because this video is going to be long, so I don't want to cover these things here. I will focus on the inspection part only. So this was about weekly inspection. So after that we have monthly inspection. So in monthly inspection, the first is turning out lifeboats. So turning out lifeboats, now this requirement to turn out the lifeboat is one monthly. Similarly, to carry out abandoned ship drill, the frequency is one monthly. So when we carry out abandoned ship drill, this turning out is also being done, because in abandoned ship drill we turn out the lifeboats, and it's also a requirement of SOLA. So that is the reason why we show the same dates for turning out lifeboats and abandoned ship drill. And turning out lifeboat means lowering the lifeboat above it is like not lowering in water, but it should be like above the water. That is what it means by turning out lifeboats. The second is inspection of lifeboat gripes and lashings. So gripes, as I already told, now these gripes which we check weekly for whether it is taut or not, in monthly inspection I will check whether this I will check the condition of the wire rope. That is the first thing. Second thing I will check is whether is it causing any chafing on the lifeboat hull, or whether the wire is getting damaged because of the chafing. So here you can see this is a packing which is put to protect the wire rope as well as the lifeboat hull. So this is a good practice which we should ensure in monthly inspection, that it is safe to secure the lifeboat with such lashing. So third thing, as you can see here, now this is the wire rope which is passing the this is the lashing of the lifeboat. Now in the bottom part we have a turnbuckle. So turnbuckle, there is a procedure to secure the turnbuckle. Now when the wire rope is connected is made with the eye, and this eye is connected to the turnbuckle with a D shackle. So you have to ensure that this is the dead end where the wire rope ends. So this dead end should meet the U-bolt. That is what it means. Now this is the U-bolt. So the dead end should be on the top. It should touch. That is what is the right procedure to secure the bulldog grip. this is the right procedure. So we have to ensure that it is properly secured with this right procedure. So this was about the checking of the condition of the lashings, and also monthly we have to grease this lifeboat gripes so that it doesn't get damaged because of external factors like wind or seawater, etc., or corrosion. Now you can see the same lifeboat gripe. Now this is the wire rope, and this is a protective cover which is there on the top of the wire rope. Now this protective cover is known as sheathing. So this, most of the lifeboats you will see that there is a sheathing on the lifeboat gripes. Now this is a wrong procedure to use a wire rope which has a sheathing. So always whenever you carry out an inspection, make sure that there is no sheathing on the wire rope. Now this is because after some time this wire rope gets corroded inside and it gets weak. Similarly, from the external, the condition of this sheathing becomes deteriorated because of the external factors, weather, and also it becomes dirty because of outside soot from the engine, etc. So when this becomes dirty, it becomes more difficult to inspect the condition of wire rope, and which is dangerous for the safety of the lifeboat. So that is why we have to make sure that there is no sheathing on the lifeboat gripes. As you can see here, this wire has a sheathing, blue color insulated material, and this is a bad practice. Similarly, this is corroded. Similarly, this also is not properly secured to the safety pin. It should not, the bulldog grip should not be connected here. It should have a permanently sliced material of wire rope. So this is the right one. As you can see here, the protective sheath is used, but it is used to prevent the chafing of the wire rope. That is why it is used. Otherwise, it is not used. So this is a good practice. So here we go for the next monthly inspection. After lifeboat gripes, we have davit and winches foundation bolts. So we have to inspect the foundation bolts. Now let us see what is foundation bolt. Now you can see here, you must be familiarized with this thing. Now this is a drum where the lifeboat falls are coiled up, and this is the motor. So below this there is a foundation of this whole unit. So this foundation, I will show you. Now this foundation has bolts fitted with the deck. As you can see here, this is a nut and bolt. So nut is not visible, bolt is visible. So now total around 6 to 8 bolts are there which are fitted, which secures the unit to the deck. Now it is very important to check whether these nuts are in good condition or whether they are corroded or they have cracks. It is very important because in one of the ship, many of the foundation bolts were found to be broken or corroded, and which led to heavy fines from the PSE. So this is what we have to check in monthly inspection about the foundation bolts. Now the next is davit greasing. So just keep a close eye on the words which I am speaking. Davit greasing. Here the winches and motors are not included. Winches and motors greasing is 3 monthly, but davit greasing is only monthly. So davit greasing, by referring to the lifeboat maker's manual, I will check where the lifeboat davit, where all the greasing points are there. So they will give you a plan where all the greasing points are marked. So based on this plan, you have to make sure that all the greasing points are highlighted yellow, as for easy identification, and you have to grease them every month. And you have to also check that there is no other old grease which is left, or it is not becoming shabby in the davit area or in the lifeboat area. You have to maintain proper cleanliness when you apply the grease. That is very important because it causes slippery surface. So while referring to the plan, you also have to ensure that the grease which you are using for greasing the davit should be as per maker's manual, should be recommended as per maker's manual. That grease only you have to use. So that is very important. Now, similarly, if you are using such type of hand grease guns or pneumatic guns, so always make sure that the greasing points near the winches and the motor, which you will be carrying out the greasing 3-monthly basis, ensure that you don't use pneumatic or like this handguns, because this will apply too much pressure and will cause the grease to enter into the brake mechanism and it will cause other problems. So it is recommended not to use any high pressure for greasing. It should be light greasing on near the winches and the brakes. After davit greasing, the next is lifeboat markings, which you have to check monthly. So lifeboat markings I have focused a lot in my previous video, so I will just not go much into detail. So lifeboat markings, you have to ensure the name of the ship, the port of registry, and then the number of lifeboat and the call sign, which should be visible from the top, and the lifeboat dimension and the maximum number of persons the lifeboat can carry. That should be highlighted or that should be marked in clear capital or letters. So that is the thing about lifeboat markings. Now, next, monthly inspection is not there. This is only the about the monthly inspection. Next will be the quarterly inspection. So quarterly inspection, the very important thing for quarterly inspection is lifeboat launching and release mechanism. So irrespective of whether it is a free fall lifeboat or a side lifeboat, you have to launch the lifeboat in the water and you have to try out the release mechanism. You have to maneuver the lifeboat, start the engine, try out the sprinkler system if it is a tanker, and you have to carry out this 3-monthly routine with irrespective of whether it is a free fall lifeboat or it is a side lifeboat. So this is very important. You have to lower the lifeboat and you have to try out the sprinklers and release mechanism. So this was about quarterly inspection for the lifeboat. Now, second thing for quarterly inspection is to inspect the lifeboat davit winch brakes. Now this comes under quarterly inspection. So I have a video to show how you will test the winch brake. Now when you lower, you have to stop in the middle abruptly so that you have to see whether the brake is being applied or not. So you have to ensure that it is the brake is being applied. So for that I have a video. So I have seen now, after that, now the next after davit winches and brakes will be davit winches and motor. So for this motor, the quarterly inspection depends on the maker's manual. Manufacturer depends on the manufacturer what inspection we need to do. So based on that, we will do the inspection of the motor. After that, we have to try out lifeboat davit limit switches. So limit switches, again, for this, I have a video. Started. So after lifeboat limit switches, we have lifeboat davit safety switch. So now this safety switch, which I am talking about, this safety switch is basically similar to limit switch. Now this is connected to the lifeboat where we put the brake handle. Now here in this location, we put the handle to heave up the lifeboat. So here you can see one switch similar to limit switch. Now if I put a handle inside this, so this limit switch will get up, and because of this, it will prevent the handle to rotate when we lower or heave the lifeboat. So that is the purpose. It is a SOLAS requirement that this safety switch should be in such a way that the handle should not rotate when we heave or lower the lifeboat. So that we have to try out every month basis. After that, we have to inspect lifeboat falls. So lifeboat falls, as you know, that there are many types of wire damages. Now abrasion, then corrosion, then core is coming out, wire core, then some fatigue due on the wire rope, then the kinked rope, and because of excessive tension, the wire rope getting damaged. So these are some of the example. So similar way, the reason to identify these problems, we have to inspect the wire rope. Similarly, you can see this is also a wire rope. Now excessive greasing is done on this wire rope. I cannot see the condition, whether any strands are coming out or any damages are there to the wire rope, because excessive greasing is done here. So whenever we are greasing, we have to ensure that we remove the old grease and then we inspect the wire rope and then we apply the new grease. So this is a very bad practice. This should not be done. Now similarly, now if I am, let's say I am inspecting a wire rope, now there is a question arising that how much breakage will let me know that I have to now condemn the wire rope. So now you can see here, as we all know, that the wire ropes have lay. So this is 1 lay, 2 lay, 3 lay, 4 lay. So 4 lay constitutes of 1 pitch. So whenever more than 10% within 1 pitch is damaged, then you have to condemn the rope. That is what it is said. So that is why you have to consider this requirement for condemning the rope. So as you can see here, now when we inspect the wire rope, we have to ensure that whenever we are lowering the lifeboat, the coiling is being done correctly, because if it is getting coiled on the top of the wire rope, it may damage the rope which is on the bottom, which is below, exactly below the wire rope. So we have to ensure whenever we are turning out the lifeboat, we have to ensure that this wire is getting coiled in a proper manner. So this is one of the inspection. Also we need to note down for carrying out inspection of lifeboat falls. So after lifeboat falls, the next is lifeboat remote lowering wire. So remote lowering wire, as you can see inside the lifeboat, this is how the remote lowering wire is, and it goes from top, it comes out of the lifeboat and there is one stopper and it goes to the pulley and then it goes down. So this is a stopper, this is a weight. Basically this is to prevent the wire rope to go inside more or to lower more. This stops the wire rope to go more, and it pulls the wire, basically the brake where it is going. So here it is going. Now this wire rope, which you can see here, now it's connected to the brake of the lifeboat, as you can see here. So this, whenever you pull the lowering wire, your brake is lifted and your lifeboat is lowered. So you have to make sure that the condition of your self-lowering wire is good, and you have to make sure that it is not in no cracks, no damages. You have to carry out greasing of this wire rope as well for your quarterly inspection. So after lifeboat remote lowering wire, this was about quarterly inspection. Now next is 6 monthly inspection. Now 6 monthly inspection is not for side lifeboats, it is for lifeboat launching and releasing mechanism or simulated launching, only for free fall lifeboats. So in free fall lifeboats, we have to launch the lifeboat by free fall 6 monthly, and if you are not carrying out free fall, then you have to carry out simulated launching. Now again, I don't want to go too much detail about simulated launching. I will make a separate video to clarify what is simulated launching, because I know this question arises whenever the free fall lifeboat topic comes. So just for this video, for the inspection purpose, we should know that 6 monthly inspection we do the free fall launch, and if not free fall launch, then simulated launching. So in this is carried out to for this inspection is carried out basically to ensure that your PIN, which is there, and your debit all are working in good condition. That is why you need to carry out this inspection to ensure that your hydraulics are working good and your PIN is getting lifted when you apply the handle. So next is annual inspection. Now, annual inspection, most of the people have doubts, so I want to clarify all each and every doubt in this video. If you have any doubt, please comment below. I hope you will understand after watching this content. So annual inspection, now it is divided into two parts. First is annual thorough examination. It is, as the word says, thorough examination, means everything, examination, inspection of everything which is related to lifeboat. And the second is thorough inspection of release mechanism. So one is about thorough inspection of everything, and the second is thorough inspection of especially release mechanism. So this is how the annual inspection is divided. And this second part, thorough inspection of release mechanism, now this is nothing but dynamic test of the winch brake. These both are the same thing. So first we will understand the annual thorough inspection. So now in annual thorough inspection, we will inspect the following things. The first thing we will inspect in the annual thorough inspection, this inspection is basically carried out in front of the service engineer. So the service engineer will basically carry out this annual inspection, and he will carry out all the inspection which are included in the weekly and monthly inspection. He will ensure that these things are proper, and after this he will carry out the inspection of the lifeboat, and he will carry out the inspection of the release gear. Now you can see the release gear, there are all the gears inside. They open annually and they check all the whether the oil inside this is not very viscous or there is no dust inside this. So they carry out an inspection for the release gear. Similarly, after release gear, they check the davits. Now the davits, they check the condition, the rust, and whether if there are any deformations on the davits or any foreplay, etc. So as you can see here, now in the davit, now whatever is related to the davit, like possible damage such as kinks and corrosion, lubrication of wires and sheaves. So they will ensure that the sheaves are rotating and the wires are lubricated, and functioning of the limit switches, that is also being tested for in the annual inspection. Then any stored power system or hydraulic system, so whatever powered system is there, so they will ensure that it is working fine. Then any corrosion, misalignment, deformation or excessive free play, so that is also they will observe in this annual thorough inspection of davits. So after davits we have winches. So in winches the brakes is also coming. So view, now this is the brake. Now this brake basically they overhaul in annual inspection. So now this brake which you can see here, now it will be overhauled. Now this brake, as you can see here, this is the weight of the brake. So and inside there is a brake mechanism. So now this is the, similarly this is the weight, and inside this gray color which you see is the brake shoe, and the dark black color is called as a brake lining. So whenever we, this is a very important thing to check, they inspect it annually. It is inspected by a whatever service engineer. So whenever this they overhaul, now you will see the pictures of getting overhauled. Now this is the picture of the brake which is overhauled. And then after that you can see inside this, now whatever, if you have done this annual inspection, you will remember that they can make people do buffing and they clean inside, they check all the teeth. Now after cleaning, you can see after the buffing and after making all things, every cleaning, and they check the inspection of the teeth and everything. So this is about annual inspection of the winch, or which includes brake also. And after that, operational onload release test. So similarly, in similar to what they do, we do in three monthly, they lower the lifeboat and they tell us to try out the sprinklers and the release mechanism. We have to release the hooks, and they will check all the sheaves or whatever they want to check with respect to the davit and the annual inspection of davit. As per their checklist, they will check. So this was about annual thorough inspection. Now the second thing is thorough inspection of release mechanism, which is nothing but dynamic test of the winch brake. So dynamic test of winch brake, now this is a very important part. Now in annual inspection, I will tell you what is done in dynamic test of winch brake. Now in dynamic test of winch brake, we apply a load. So the load applied is nothing but the weight of the lifeboat and its equipments. So here the weight of persons is not applied, only weight of lifeboat and its equipment. So this much weight is applied on the lifeboat davit, and the lifeboat is lowered with the max lowering speed, and then the brake is applied abruptly, and they have to check whether the dynamic test of the winch brake is working or not. It is to test the brake. I repeat, it is to test the brake. So we have to try out abruptly by stopping the lowering, and we have to check whether the brake is holding or not. So the load applied will be only the weight of the lifeboat and its equipment. Now, very important. Now, this dynamic load test, as you can see here, first we will lower the lifeboat, apply the brake, check the davit structure, whether it is holding it or not, or any deformations or any defects. Then we will, after we have applied the brake, we again re-inspect the brake pads. I already shown you the brake pads, the dark color ones. So we have to re-inspect, and after that they will secure everything, secure if everything is good. So this is what happens in dynamic winch brake test. Now this dynamic test of winch brake is divided in two parts, that is first annually also and 5-yearly also. So in both these inspections, this dynamic test of winch brake is carried out, but the weight applied will be different. Now let me go into detail. So in annual inspection, I already told you guys that the weight which is applied, is the load which is applied is different, and in 5-yearly load is applied, but it is called as a proof load applied. Now proof load means that applying, it is a tensile force which is applied before the object gets deformed, that is called as proof load. So the name of the loads are different here, just remember that. Now in annual inspection, the load which we are applying will be weight of lifeboats and its equipments. Similarly, in 5-yearly also we will do the same, but in 5-yearly there will be additional things. The second thing is here the max number of persons into 82.5 kg is applied. Now let's say if the lifeboat can carry 20 persons maximum, so 20 into 82.5 kg. This weight will also be added to the weight of the lifeboat. Now here, this is 82.5 kg. Now, for ships which are built after 1 July 2010, for those ships, this amount, this quantity of weight will be applied, that is 82.5 kg. But if the ship is built before 1 July 2010, then the person weight will be taken as 75 kg. But only for ships which are built after 1st July 2010 is 82.5 kg. And for passenger ships, it is standard, that is 75 kg. So keep this in mind. Now, the weight of the lifeboat and its equipment plus the max number of persons into 82.5 kg. Now, whatever the weight which is there, the sum of both the things into 1.1 times you have to do. That is your proof load. Proof load is equivalent to weight of the lifeboat and its equipment plus max number of persons into 82.5 kg. and it will be a product of 1.1 times of the above load. So this is the above load, both this load. So 1.1 times of this total weight. So this is what is to be, this is the load which is applied in 5-yearly inspection. And this is the load which is applied in annual inspection. So I hope this is clear to you. If you have any doubts, you can comment below. Now, this proof load or whatever annual inspection, this now 5-yearly inspection can be is carried out in dry dock. So yeah, as we completed this, now in this it is carried out in dry dock. So the weight which we are carrying in the lifeboat, now either we can load the lifeboat with the gunny bags with sand whatever, or you can directly apply lift the weight, heavy weight from the davit. That can be done in the dry dock. Okay, so now we were here. Now I hope annual inspection is clear, because annual inspection consists of two things. One is dynamic test of the winch brake, and second is annual thorough inspection. I hope this annual inspection is clear to you guys, and also the dynamic test is clear. Now next thing is 4 or 5 yearly inspection. Now in this comes lifeboat falls renewal. Now this renewal of lifeboat falls depends on the what the maker says. Some says 4 years, some says 5 year. That is why I have written 4 or 5 year. But you have to make sure that it doesn't exceed 5 years. The second is inspection of winches and motor. This is also to be done 4 or 5 yearly, depending on the maker's advice or maker manufacturer's instruction. Third is lifeboat launching and release mechanism. Similar, this is nothing but, as you can see the words, lifeboat launching and release mechanism. This is dynamic test of winch brake, which I explained you just now, which I carried out a comparison between annual and 5 yearly. This is the 5 yearly inspection, dynamic test of winch brake, as I've shown here. This test has to be carried out in this 4 or 5 yearly inspection. So this all consists of 4 or 5 yearly inspection. And other than this, we have, now you can see here, this is how the weight is being subjected to the free fall lifeboat davit and for carrying out the dynamic test. So it's not necessary that you load the lifeboat with all the gunny bags and the sandbags. You can carry simple weights which are as per the maker's manual, whatever weight is given, the maximum proof load as per calculation. So you have to load that weight, and you can try out if the hydraulics and the davit is holding, or it can be it can hold. So the dynamic test is passed. I mean to say, as you apply the abrupt brakes, if it is stopping, if the brake is being applied, your dynamic test is passed. So this was about dynamic test. Now after this, we have FPD's inspection. Now this is also depending on maker's manufacturer's instruction. Some say that FPDs should be renewed after 5 years, some say after 4 years. So it all depends, but make sure that if you have a FPD on board, make sure that how much, what is the, whether it is inspected or not, or you have a certificate of inspection 4-yearly or 5-yearly, depending upon the manufacturer instruction. So this was all about lifeboat davits, launching and recovery arrangements, right from weekly inspection to 4 or 5 yearly inspection. I hope I have put my all efforts to explain you guys. So if you have any doubts, you can comment below. Now I have successfully completed my explanation for this part, lifeboat davits, launching and recovery arrangements. Now in my next video, I will be explaining about engines, batteries and lightings. So guys, I hope you have understood, and if you have any doubts, please comment below. So guys, if you like this video, please like, subscribe and comment, and thanks for watching, guys.